1, 2, 3. Are you ready?
Welcome back to Do Science with Dom, and I'm Dominique with the St. Louis Public Library, and today we're going to learn about heat absorption by making ice cream in a bag. The ingredients you will need for this experiment is a half a cup of milk, or you could use half and half, 1 tablespoon of sugar, a half teaspoon of vanilla extract, some ice, a half a cup of rock salt, 2 sandwich-sized baggies, and 2 gallon-sized baggies. And you also might want to use some gloves. Now that we have all our ingredients, we can now begin this experiment. First, I would like you to take your sandwich-sized Ziploc bag and pour in a half a cup of milk. Then I would like for you to add 1 tablespoon of sugar. Next, you're going to add in a half teaspoon of vanilla extract. Get all of the air out of your bag as much as you can, and then make sure it's sealed tightly. Then you want to take this bag and place it inside of another bag. And make sure that it's sealed tightly. All right, now that you have your double bag tightly sealed, I want you to place that bag inside of a gallon bag. Once you have your 2 sandwich bags inside of the gallon bag, you can now add in a half a cup of your rock salt. Once you place that inside the bag, seal it tight, make sure that all the air out, and then place it inside of another gallon bag. This might be where you want to use your gloves, because we're going to put this bag that we made inside of a bag of ice. Make sure that it's sealed tightly so you won't have a mess on your hands. Because once we put that bag inside of our bag of ice, we are going to shake for about 15 to 20 minutes. So you might need a parent to get a timer and time you guys. I'm gonna start mine now. Start shaking. All right, now that you're done shaking for about 15 to 20 minutes, you should be all done. You could take your smaller Ziploc bag out of your gallon bag, and your ice cream should be in the bag. Let's take a scoop of it and see. Tastes just like ice cream. How did this work? Well, let me explain. The salt lowers the temperature at which the ice freezes,
and rises the temperature at which it melts, which is why we use salt on roads and sidewalks during snowy days. Instead of the ice melting at 32 degrees Fahrenheit, the rock salt causes the ice to melt at a temperature much lower, depending on how much salt you add. The more rock salt you use, the lower the temperature of the ice will melt at. This creates an environment that the ice cream mixture can freeze below the normal 32 degrees. The salt ice sludge then absorbs the heat from the cream mixture, lowering the temperature of the cream, causing the cream to ice, creating the yummy ice cream. Now that we're done with our experiment, I would like to tell you about our summer challenge before you go. The summer challenge is where you can read books and do activities to get a prize from us. If you would like to learn more about the summer challenge, check out slpl.org or visit the library near you. See you guys next time. Bye.
That's one small step for man.